this video, we're gonna try to fix the steering on my car. So it's always steered like shit because I've never gotten a proper alignment, but we have GK Tech caster arm to install. So these are the GK Tech V5 caster arms. At the moment I have hard race caster arms in my car, but I bought S14 version ones, which I don't think is right. So they're actually longer, and ever since I've been driving this car, like, it hasn't really steered that well. So I'm hoping that installing the right S13 caster arm will have the proper adjustment. And then I'm gonna try to get a proper alignment as well, because I've always gone to like the local dude and they only do toe adjustments. They never do caster or camber or anything like that. So hopefully we get the steering feeling good and ready for my next drift event, which is the 19th of July at Pheasantwood. So GK Tech has this printout which kind of shows the lengths. So you can see from this printout that the OEM length of an S13 is 355 millimeters, whereas the S14 is 377 millimeters. But basically this car has only driven kind of okay with the hard race arms at the shortest. So there's basically no adjustment when I put the S14 arms in. Hopefully this makes a difference and I get the right lengths required. Should be an easy install, so we'll get to it. This is a hard race caster arm. When I bought this, I bought the S14 version instead of S13. And the reason why I did that was because I thought that that's what you needed to do, because I've swapped the LCAs to S14. But it should be really straightforward. There's just two bolts here and then this bolt here that we gotta remove. All right, so I got the hard race tension arm out, and this is a comparison with the GK Tech. I don't actually know if it's a big deal or not. The S14 tension arm's a bit longer than the GK Tech, so that's why I'm gonna try to swap to this one and see if it does any better. So on my Instagram page, I asked for recommendations on where to get a wheel alignment. And basically everyone said Porter's Performance, so that's who I'm going to try to go with. Hopefully they have some availabilities next week, because I'll need to get this aligned ASAP. Also, while we're at it, I've got new Project Mu brake pads to swap out. Yeah, that's done. I've just finished the other side. We did the brake pads as well as the caster arm, and now we've just got to do the driver side. My camera's about to run out of battery, so I'll probably just cut straight to having this on the car. Tuesday morning, so we're heading over to Porter Performance now. You can see how bad the alignment is. Four fingers. And the other side, it's a much tighter, it's more like three. I think I'm just gonna drop it off with him. There's a climbing gym nearby, so if I don't need to hang around, then I'll probably just leave the car with him and then try out, it's called Climb Fit Kiriwi. I've never been there before, so we'll see how we go. So the car's been aligned in my frame. The car's been aligned at Porter's Performance. And then now I've got two more things I need to do, which is just swap the welded diff back in. And then I also bought a replacement front handbrake cable. The new front handbrake cable. So this is genuine Nissan. A couple of weeks ago, I replaced the back handbrake cables with GK Tech ones, and it made the handbrake feel even worse. So I'm hoping this fixes my problem. Okay, so giving you guys a quick look of the handbrake assembly in an S13. You gotta remove the center console here. If I put the new one here, there's just two bolts that hold this down here. This part goes underneath the car and this attaches to the rear handbrake cables. And I think the only kind of hard part will be this part here. So that there is a rivet. I don't know the exact name of it, but these are like compression rivets or something like that. I don't really have any tools that can compress the new one. So we're gonna have to drill that out to remove the old one. And the new one, honestly, I think I might just be able to just leave it there without compressing it, because it's just the sleeve aspect of the cable, because the actual cable is underneath, and then this is just like protection. So we'll see how we go. So that's the old cable out. So now you can see old cable, new cable. So that's the new handbrake cable installed. It might need a bit of adjustment. Once the car's back and rolling, I'll probably give it a street test and see if it's any better. Handbrake works okay, and water diff is pretty good. So thanks for watching, I'll see you guys next time.